Hey, you crazy bunch of bananas, the 8-Bit Monkey here, and welcome back to Seed Sunday, the time of the week when I give you a brand new seed to come enjoy and hopefully have a bit of fun with. And this week's seed is both beautiful, but also very, very deadly. So without further ado, let's just jump in and see what this week's seed has to offer. So as always, the coordinates on the top left-hand side of the screen, as well as the seed being on the top right-hand side of the screen, as well as being in the video description down below. So go copy and paste the seed from the video description, put your own world, enjoy this new seed for this fine Sunday. So as you can see, the reason I say this is one of the most dangerous seeds in all of Minecraft is because you will spawn in front of this pillager outpost. Now, right now, I'm safe. I'm in creative mode. But if you were to load the seed up in survival, these guys will instantly, and I mean instantly, run you down. They will come towards you with their multi-shot crossbows here and just basically completely annihilate you. So, if you are loading the seed in survival, the first thing you need to do is spawn in like this and then run the frick away, because these guys will not stop chasing you until you are a good distance from them. I loaded the seed in survival early on. I got as far as here and they were still coming after me. So I had to keep going further and further through the water and stuff like that. It was difficult. So if you are wanting a challenge, definitely check out the seed. Load it up, starting right in front of this thing right here. And, you know, good luck. Very much good luck. Now, if you can make your way back here, once you maybe got sell some kit armor and everything like that, you can take, oh my god, there's so many of them. And they just keep generating in. But like, if I was to kill all these guys, they will generate more in this exact location, because this is basically a massive spawner. They'll always generate in this area. And yeah, there's quite a lot of them. But if you can make your way back here with maybe some decent armor, get to the top of here and get into this chest, you will find yourself some nice loot as well. Unfortunately, the loot in these things are completely random for the pillager outpost, so I got this time. Last time I loaded the seed, I got a really nice enchanted book with multi-shot. So your content may vary for what I got, but hopefully it'd be better loot than this and it'd be worthwhile coming all the way back and taking on all of these wonderful, wonderful pillagers. There are just so many of them. So another thing that the seed offers you, which is pretty damn sweet, is there is a ship right next to spawn as well. So you do have a way of getting some loot really easy in the game for starting off. So we go into this little area right here. There is a chest, and inside the chest you got yourself a bunch of emeralds. You got yourself some iron, some gold nuggets, and some iron nuggets as well. So not too bad. You can get yourself a sword, maybe make yourself a chest plate or something like that. So, you know, starting off a decent amount of loot to start off. Now, if you're wanting a bit more, you go down into the bottom area here, and there is another chest. And in this chest here, we have ourselves some paper, some feathers, and a buried treasure map as well. Now, this buried treasure map does give you some treasure, but it's a little bit of a distance. So if you can see in the top right-hand corner of the map, there is a little tiny dot. That is you. It's so small because you're quite a ways away from where the loot is. So you're going to have to travel quite a bit to get to the loot. But once you get there, hopefully, just hopefully, you have some really cool loot waiting for you. Now, if we dig our way through the bottom of this ship and just go forward ever so slightly, there should be another chest somewhere around here. Whereabouts is it? Where is that other button? Somewhere around here. There it is. Okay, I was a little bit off. It's right here, and I need to break that and then break that there. Okay, so in this chest, you get yourself some potatoes, which isn't too bad. Start a potato farm pretty easily. You got yourself some TNT and some leather pants with projectile protection 1, which, let's face it, with those guys over there, might be pretty damn useful, especially if you want to get, like, you know, there without dying constantly. Now, I did say that this seed had a bit of beauty to it as well. You do have some bees, which if you are into bees and you want some beautiful bees, there are some honey hives everywhere in this map as well. There's one right there, and there's one on the island just over there. So, easy way of getting bees if you can, you know, like I say, bypass these guys. But as I said, this does have a lot of beauty to it as well, because there is a coral reef right behind where those pillagers are. So if you can get past these guys, maybe get in a boat and just sail around the complete outskirts, there is a wonderful, beautiful coral reef waiting for you, because this thing is so pretty. Like, this one's a little bit small, tiny bit small, but if we go this way a little bit more, just look at this. It is so vast and beautiful, and I would just love to live in a coral reef in Minecraft. That would be so much fun. I mean, granted, I would need insane amounts of water breathing potions, but just look at this. It is so pretty. so colorful and so pretty. Now, there is more to this coral reef than meets the eye. There is a sunken ship and a drowned village as well. So, yes, granted, you go to the overworld and you've got yourself the pillagers which you have to take on. And when you come in the water, you got, you know, drowns that you need to take on. But just look at the value that you get. You got all these fishes, and it's just so pretty. I absolutely love coral reefs, seriously, guys. So, there are a bunch of drowns here, but they just offer you a few bits of loot as well. So in this chest here, we got ourselves another buried treasure map. Make sure to open this away from this one, away from this area, otherwise you'll get the same loot. Some wheat and some coal. Not great, I'll be honest. Not great at all. If we go over to this one just over here, I can swim in water, be really nice. If we go over to this one just over here, there should be another chest just here with a bunch of wheat there, some rotten flesh, some coal, and a curse of vanishing fishing rod. Absolutely pointless. So we don't need to go into that chest there. It's completely waste time. But if we go to this one, which is just in here, we got ourselves a Look of the Sea 3. So worthwhile coming to this one at least to getting that Look of the Sea 3 and some coal there and some a stone pickaxe and some wheat as well. So not terrible, not great, I grant you, but also not terrible. And then there is one more chest just over here that I'll show you, which is under this block. Yep, right there, with a golden apple. Absolutely fantastic. If you're wanting to survive and, you know, like, get some health back from maybe taking out all the drones, then the golden apple is the way to go, with a bunch of golden nuggets there and some coal and some wheat. So pretty decent loot. Not the most amazing loot in the world, but still pretty decent. Now, this thing I absolutely love as well. This ship has been taken over by all of the, you know, the growing grass and stuff like that, the water grass, but also the coral. It looks so freaking beautiful. Just look at this. Like, the coral's just kind of taking over the inside of this place. You got bits of corals outside of here. It looks so pretty. So in this chest here, you got yourselves a bunch of iron with a bunch of iron nuggets, as well as some gold and a diamond as well. So not too shabby. A diamond is always nice to get. Free diamonds at the end of the day is always a nice diamond. And if we go on down through the bottom of here, as you can see, once again, the coral has taken over the ship, and it looks so nice. Just having that bit of coral there just makes me feel more like a shipwreck than just, hey, here's a ship under the water. Now, in this chest here, we've got ourselves another buried treasure map. So once again, open this far away from where you open this one, far away from where you open this one. Otherwise, we'll get the same loot every single time, okay? I'll even prove it. Watch. I open this one now. It's the same loot. It's a different map, but it's the same loot. Completely wasted time. So, if you open this chest here, you've got some more paper, some feathers, which isn't too bad if you want to get yourself maybe, I don't know, some arrows. Feathers are useful sometimes. And then finally, this chest right here, you got yourself some wheat, some gunpowder, some more rotten flesh, a pumpkin to start pumpkin farm pretty straight away in the game, and some gunpowder with some suspicious stew. So, if you are taking these stews, be really careful, because they're suspicious, and you shouldn't eat suspicious foods, okay? In real world. But in Minecraft, go ahead, eat all the suspicious food that you want, because let's face it, sometimes it gives you really good stuff, and sometimes not so much. But hey guys, that is it for this week's seed. I hope you have enjoyed. If you have, a like would be much appreciated. Pop into the seed, check out the coral reef, check out all these beautiful fish that just swim around the coral reef, and just explore this place, because realistically, this is one of the most beautiful, yet also most deadly seeds in my Seed Sunday series. So check it out. Come swim with the dolphins, and until next time, TTYL, peace out, and bye-bye. Tunas, you crazy ones, bananas. It looks so pretty down here. I want to live in the coral reef. My face is so close to the camera. Why? Stop it. There you go. Bye, guys. See you next time for another Seed Sunday. Oops. And what Seed Sunday will be complete without the Amplified section, the time after credits, when I show you what the seed looks like in Amplified, that set we all love, but unfortunately everyone can run. As always, I give you a word you put in the comments down below, so I know that you stay till after credits. You're top banana, and you're amazing. You don't get anything from it, past the surprise and joy. That's you, yes, you are a top banana. So thank you so much for being a top banana, sticking around today after the credits, and just supporting the channel in the way that you do. It means the absolute world to me, genuinely it does. And if you are watching these videos, enjoying them, be sure to click that bell, click the subscribe button, click the like button, and share it with your friends. You know, you can't talk to them right now, but hey, share videos. That's the way to go. So this week's word, in celebration of the new UHC series that we start with, the World of Madness, this week's word is going to be shield. Now, what is the reason the word is shield? Tell me in the comments down below. If you've watched this video and you watched the latest UHC as well, you'll know why the word shield is important. And, you know, Put it in the comments down below. I want to know how many people are watching both videos. Yeah, that's important, right? Watch more videos. Right. So anyway, guys, put the word shield in the comments down below. Like I say, you don't get anything from it, so it's a pride and joy that you, yes, you are a top banana. So thank you so much for being a top banana. It genuinely means the world to me. So the outpost is still here, and this is what the world looks like in Outified. Okay, this side, rubbish. That side, whoa. That looks amazing. Okay, I'm going to go that way in a bit, but I just want to kind of look at this. This thing looks phenomenal. Oh, wow. Oh, this is so nice. Oh, it's still loading. There's more. Oh, this is so pretty. Okay, so I know I say I like Amplified a lot, and I really do love Amplified, but I usually love Amplified when it's inside of, like, I don't know, like, deserts and stuff like that, because I kind of get, like, you get this terrain in deserts. This thing in plains or in mountains is insane. I love this. It is so pretty. Look at all the waterfalls and the landmass is just holding up from the floor. It looks... Oh, there's more over there. Okay, yeah, I'm really happy with this Amplified. This is so nice. You got these overhangs. You've got these bridges, like these stone bridges and stuff like that. You got just floating landmasses, which, you know, totally obeying the laws of gravity. You got some lovely... Oh, one cow. One cow just living up here by itself. Oh, poor thing. Where's your friends? Where's all your friends, buddy? I'm so sorry. You got no friends up here. Okay. It looks like you're in the clouds, by the way. But yeah, look at this thing. It's so pretty. Oh, you got pigs over here. Pigs over here, guy. Pigs. You got creepers. Don't worry about this. But anyway, yeah. This thing looks amazing. Okay, yeah. So this is what looks like Amplified. This is what this bit looks like Amplified. Absolutely wonderful. Absolutely amazing. Let's check out the parts where we're actually seeing in the default world. So as you can see, the pillager outpost is still there. And it hasn't really changed much. It's kind of gone up, obviously. But this area, it's not the greatest. I'll be honest. Like, this bit here doesn't look too impressive. Although, this is here now. This wasn't here in the default, I don't think. I don't think we had this little tent. So that's new. But there is this overhang, which looks kind of cool. So it's got this overhang of land here. You got that bee minister still there. You got the hive and stuff. But yeah, not much has changed too much when it comes to, like, you know, the height. I like a bit more height. But let's go and check out the coral reef anyway. So coral reef is still there. Nothing's changed there. The coral reef will always be there. It's not going to change at all. But yeah, that's pretty much it for the coral reef. So let's go back to the other part. The part that looks really cool and really impressive. So if we go over that way, we'll find the highest point in the game that we can find. Well, in this area of the map that we can find. Which, let's face it, it's going to be way up there. Way, way, way up there. And let's see if we can get up there right now. How high is this anyway? Is this like world height? This actually might be world height. 252? Okay, it's close to world height. World height is 255. What we're going to do, we're going to go to the very, very tip of the end here. Right? Oh, no, don't fall yet. That's not the goal. The goal is to die in a bit. So, actually, are we going to die or survive? Ooh, depends if I hit that landmass or I hit there. I'm going to, we'll see. So, as always, go to the highest point that I can find. I grant you, that is there, but I'm saying it here. So, I'm going to go into game mode survival like that. Go into F5 mode, and as you can see, I fixed my tail! Yay, finally! It only took me, what, like 5 weeks? So, tail's now fixed. It looks like a tail. Kind of looks like a tail. The head kind of covers most of it up. But hey, my tail's there now. Yay! So, give him a mungle a little shave here. There you go. Go into F5 mode, and I hope you enjoyed this, guys. If you did, I like it, much appreciated. It helps the channel up so much. And until next time, TTYL. Peace out. And bye-bye. Tunes your creation for bananas. Live or die. Live or die. Live or die. Live or die. Wait, how did I live? Okay, that makes more sense. That makes far more sense. Lagadai, lagadai. Bye, guys. This was like in survival. This was like in survival. This was like in survival. Please run away in survival. Dear God, they won't stop chasing me. Help, Jeebus. Help me. They're just going to keep chasing me, aren't they? Yeah. Yeah, they're going to keep coming at me. I just keep running. Just keep running. Bye, guys. swimming along on the bottom of the beautiful briny sea. Oh, they're still coming. I'm going to keep running.